Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh, and welcome to episode 10 of Qur'an Connect, a series through which we are hoping to connect with the Qur'an one juz at a time in this blessed month of Ramadan. Subhanallah, we are now on the 10th juz of the Qur'an, the 10th portion, and we are on a new surah, Surah At-Tawbah. It's that surah that you've probably recited in the Qur'an, you've come across it and you've realized that there's no Bismillah at the beginning. There's no basmala at the beginning. Not something that we can discuss today, unfortunately, but it's actually something really interesting that you should research yourselves and look into why there's no bismillah at the beginning of this surah. But anyway, we're going to look at more specifically, we're going to look at verse number 51 in Surah At-Tawbah. And it's an extremely important lesson for us all, a life lesson that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala teaches us in a direct address to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, قُلْ say, O Muhammad, لَنْ يُصِيبَنَا إِلَّا مَا كَتَبَ اللَّهُ لَنَا. That which was not written for us will never ever afflict us. It's not going to happen. It's not going to come to us. If Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has not written something for you, then it just won't happen. So the mukhalif meaning that we take, the absolute opposite meaning that we take from this is that which was written for us will most definitely afflict us. Subhanallah, such a beautiful life lesson that we take, such a beautiful life lesson that we learn from the Qur'an. How is it a life lesson? What do we learn from this? Because many a time, you know, there might be that person that we wanted to marry. There might be, you know, that job that we really wanted. There might be some sort of rizq that we thought might come into our provision, our possession, but it didn't. Well, always keep in mind, and this is something that should always keep you content, that if it wasn't written for you, then it really never was meant to happen. And this was a plan of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If it is written for you, then, you know, doesn't matter what you do or what you don't do, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will present it to you at some point. And even if you don't get what you wanted, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give you something even better. So keep this in mind. This is the first part of the verse where we learn something that's written for us will most definitely attain it. Then Allah says, Huwa Mawlana. He is our protector, he's our guardian, he's our friend. There's so many different meanings for Mawla in the Arabic language, right? Someone who's beloved, someone who's close to us. And again, it's something that we learn that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is teaching us that he is our Mawla. He is the one that's looking out for us. And imagine if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, out of all people, out of all beings, is the one that is looking out for us, then, you know, who is this person or that person? Who's this friend or that friend to protect us or to have our back, for example? You know, nowadays we want, you know, a group of men or a group of boys that we've known for so long that, you know, that have our back, and we say, yeah, you know, through thick and thin, these people have my back. Well, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying he'll have your back. Why? Because you're going to rely on him truly. And in the third part of the verse, in the same verse, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَعَلَى اللَّهِ فَلْيَتَوَكَّلِ الْمُؤْمِنُونَ. And upon Allah, let the believers have tawakkul. And upon Allah, let the believers rely upon. Let the believers truly rely upon Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the final part of the verse. Tawakkul, having full reliance in Allah, is so important. It's a key to living your life in a content and happy manner. Because you know, when you have tawakkul upon Allah, when you tie that camel and you have tawakkul and you leave it with Allah, and you have to do your best firstly. Don't have fake tawakkul, or don't have what we call tamanni. Don't just wish and have these fake hopes in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Don't do that. Don't just say, okay, I'm going to sit at home now and, you know, I'm going to read a book here and there. I'm not going to make any effort. I'm not going to travel. I'm not going to go to any classes. But, you know, I have tawakkul in Allah. He is going to make me a scholar. He's going to make me a person of knowledge. It's not going to happen. Or, you know, I'm not going to work. I'm going to sit at home. And inshallah, I'm going to have tawakkul in Allah. He's going to provide for me. It doesn't work like that, unfortunately. You know, that would have been really easy. Fortunately, it doesn't work like that. What we need to do is we need to put the effort in. We need to work hard ourselves. Once we've put the effort in, once we've tied our camel, only then we have tawakkul in Allah. You do your best. You put the hard work in. You put the hours in, right? After that, then you say, I rely upon Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, I have full tawakkul in Allah, reliance in Allah, then you will see the results. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will be truly happy with you. And then, if it's written for you, going back to the first part of the verse, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will grant it to you. If it's not written for you, then there's not much more you can do. Even if you work 24 hours a day, that rizq wasn't supposed to come to you, it will not come to you. So keep in mind this tawakkul that we have in Allah. And again, we're going to look at another part of the Qur'an, Surah At-Talaq, where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَمَن يَتَوَكَّلَ عَلَى اللَّهِ. Whomsoever has tawakkul, whomsoever relies upon Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, فَهُوَ حَسْبُهُ. then surely he is sufficient for him. This person won't need anyone else. إِنَّ اللَّهَ بَالِغُ أَمْرِهِ Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will ensure that he reaches the point where he wanted to reach. If you've got a goal and you've got that in mind and you've worked hard and then you have tawakkul, then Allah says he is the one that will allow you to reach that place or that destination, right? Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the one that brings about ease after hardship. This is the beauty of tawakkul. This is the beauty of relying upon Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is the beauty of, you know, putting in the effort and then letting Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala do the rest. So what do we take away from this beautiful verse in Surah At-Tawbah? That number one, always keep in mind that if it's not written for you, it's not meant to be. Number two, you have to keep in mind that Allah is your protector. Allah has your back. And number three, what you need to keep in mind is that have full tawakkul in Allah after you've gone through the necessary measures. If you've done this, then I promise it's a valuable life lesson. You can live your life in the best way and you can be happy. You can do whatever you need to do and then rely on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala because He will be there to have your back. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us the tawfiq. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala always be there for us and answer our prayers and give us the best in this life. Ameen. Wa akhiru da'wana and alhamdulillahi rabbil alameen. Until next time, wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.